may indicate present world conflict. others, and to this group is a unit of several souls. Forget not that such a unit is in itself a separated concept from the angle of the greater whole. It will serve a useful purpose in training the group members to think in those wider terms. It serves as a stepping stone away from the consciousness of the isolated personality. Copyright 1998 Lucas Trust. 210. A Treatise on the Seven Rays, Volume 4, Esoteric Healing. If you can indeed feel, think and function as one complete unit, several personalities and one soul, it will then be relatively easy to extend the concept to a broader inclusiveness, to broaden your horizon and thus become inclusive in a much wider sense. The using of the mind to this end involves an aptitude to learn the distinction between analysis and criticism. This is a hard and well-nigh impossible thing for many to learn. Traces of illumination of this subject will show themselves if the group persists in all earnestness. The members have to learn to respond, as a group, to the same spiritual, mental and human ideas, and thus swing, as a telepathic unit, into one united train of thought. They have, as a group, to be preoccupied with the same things which are indicated by the soul of the group, and not by one person in the group, as is apt to be the case. They have to learn, as a group, to hold the mind steady in the light, the group mind, and not their individual mind. In using the imagination to this end, you have to cultivate the power to ignore the outer forms and to concentrate on the inner lines of light which unite brother to brother, group to group, and kingdom to kingdom in the expression of the life of God Himself. It is the creative use of the imagination which produces an integrated group apparent body and which enables you to see this group body of force and light as one complete form and as one expression of the group. Intelligence, will and purpose, but not the will or purpose of the dominant mind or minds in the group. Thus these can work out on the physical plane in right expression. However, when the group members are primarily occupied with their own ideas, their plans, their problems, and how they can use whatever light and knowledge may be received, they negate any possibility of such creative use of the united imagination. To become entirely free from this will take much careful cultivation and self-surrender to the soul. On healing energy. The question is sometimes asked by beginners, can we clearly distinguish between the healing energy, as expressed by the soul and by the personality? Can we have some understanding of the part that love has to play in the art of healing? I can answer with brevity. When we come to work as a group with individuals whom we shall seek to aid, we shall then learn to use the various types of energy according to the need of the individual to be healed. It would serve a real good purpose if all of you would study what is said by Rama Prasad in his book, Nature's Finer Forces, and by Patanjali in The Light of the Soul on the subject of the pranas position within which you work. You should be somewhat familiar with the matter. To answer the question specifically, an initiate or even a low-grade clairvoyant can easily ponder upon this phrase, and love is all that is. The main characteristic of the distinction between soul energy and personality force, as applied to healing, lies in the region of the application and the expression of love. Personality force is emotional, full of healing, and, when in use, the personality is either conscious of itself as the healer, and is the dramatic center of the stage upon which are two